afternoon and welcome to our traditional carol service of readings and carols. The service will run itself. We'll stand for the carols, we'll sit for the readings, we'll sit for the choir piece, and later on my colleague Reverend Pat will give us our address. Everything you need should be in this order of service and on the screens above. But now I think we'll start with our first carol.
Thank you.
please sit as we come to pray. We have come together as the family of God in our Father's presence to celebrate the great festival of Christmas. In this service, we hear and receive the good news of the birth of Christ, and we offer to God our thanksgiving in the joyful singing of carols. As we gather together in the name of Christ, we pray for the world he came to save. For the church, that it may be enabled in our generation to surrender anew to God's holy wisdom and bear the good news of God's love to a needy world. For the world, that all its peoples may recognise their responsibility for its future and be inspired by the message of Christmas to work together for the establishment of justice, freedom and peace everywhere. For all in special need, the sick, the anxious, the lonely, the fearful and the bereaved, that the peace and light of Christ may bring hope and healing to all who sit in darkness. We commend all whom we love, all who have asked for our prayers to the unfailing mercy of our Heavenly Father, and say the Lord's Prayer together as Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah, predicting the coming of Christ. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For us, a child is born, to us, a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called the Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness. From the time on and forever, the zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. angel Gabriel visits the Virgin Mary. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to you, God.
I'm
born in Bethlehem. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belongs to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Visit the manger. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. This is the word of the Lord.
Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the time of King Herod. Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem, in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel."
Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child, and as soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Waiting for the school nativity play to begin. The hall was packed with proud parents, grandparents, carers, and siblings. Then the school choir began to sing Little Donkey as Mary and Joseph made their way slowly towards the stage, on which was a cleverly made large cardboard door. Climbing the steps, Joseph pretended to knock on the door while sound effects produced a loud rat-a-tat-tat. The innkeeper emerged from behind the door. Keeping to the script, Joseph asked if there was a room at the inn for him and his wife Mary. But the innkeeper, seeing for the first time the large audience, all those eyes looking at him, froze with stage fright, rabbit in the headlights. Staring at the audience, he didn't even hear Joseph's words, and he certainly didn't reply. Joseph rolled his eyes and asked again, "Have you got a room in the inn for me and my wife?" This time there was a response from the innkeeper. He only had one word to say, and he chose the wrong one as he firmly replied, "Yes." With his back to the audience and unseen by them, Joseph looked horrified, mouthing, "No, no, no," to the innkeeper. Then asked again in his loudest voice, "Have you got a room in the inn for me and my wife?" The innkeeper, still in his frozen world, answered again, "Yes." Mary, being quick thinking, decided to take things into her own hands. "Perhaps there is a stable we could sleep in," she said. However, by this time, the innkeeper had got himself together and picked up the frantic signals Joseph was sending him. So in answer to Mary's inquiry, "Perhaps there is a stable we could sleep in," he slowly shook his head and said, "No." Seeing this might get worse before it got better, one of the teachers jumped on the stage, taking Mary and Joseph by the hand and said loudly, "Let's go and find the stable we are going to stay in," whilst another teacher ushered the stage-struck innkeeper off in the other direction. And I can imagine there was rapturous applause. Yeah. And I'm sure we all know that it's very easy to make a mistake and say or do the wrong thing. Looking at the story of the Nativity, it could seem as if the whole thing was a mistake. So in the Bible, there was no room at the inn for Mary and Joseph, and they had to stay in a stable or a cave-like place where the animals were sleeping. And this was where Mary gave birth to Jesus. What was God thinking of allowing his only son to be born in such poor surroundings? Surely nobody would plan this kind of arrival for their newborn baby, would they? It would seem the only sensible people in the story were the aptly named wise men, who in their quest to find the king had naturally took their search to a palace. But actually, Jesus' arrival on earth was exactly as God had planned it. There'd been many prophecies given hundreds of years before that indicated Jesus would be born in Bethlehem in this most unusual way. But it's not the sort of arrival on earth that you might plan for the Son of God, is it? And then came what must have seemed an even greater mistake. Jesus, born as that baby in such poor surroundings, was eventually put to death on a cross. What's that all about? Well, taking on the sins of the whole world, the sins of all of us. That's why Jesus died on that cross. But for Jesus, death was not to be the end. As we celebrated Easter, Jesus rose again from that death to put an end to dying so that we could all have new life with him. God does not make mistakes. He created each one of us, and not one of us is a mistake, although perhaps sometimes we feel as if we are. God created us because he loves us, and because he loves us, he sent his only son, Jesus, into the world to save us. A version of the Bible called The Message puts it very well. It reads, "This is how much God loved the world. He gave his son, his one and only son, And this is why, so that no one need be destroyed. By believing in him, anyone can have a whole and lasting life. God didn't go to all the trouble of sending his son merely to point an accusing finger, telling the world how bad it is. He came to help, to put the world right again. So as we prepare for Christmas, let's try to remember that important message most of all. Maybe taking it on board for the first time, maybe renewing our faith. However we may celebrate Christmas Day, whoever we may be with, or even if we're on our own, can we perhaps take a moment to consciously remember the baby Jesus and to be aware of the reason behind our celebration, if you like, the reason for the season. To take on board the amazing thing that God planned, that great event that we are celebrating, the greatest event of all, the birth of Jesus, who God sent into the world to save us, because God loves us so much. As we're going to sing in a few minutes, the words of the chorus from Once in Royal David City. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, as we prepare with joy to celebrate the gift of the Christ child, embrace the earth with your glory, and be for us a living hope in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.